When it comes to transitioning to Linux, one of the main reasons some users abandon this intention is the inability to run certain Windows applications such as Visual Studio, AutoCAD, Photoshop and others. WinBoat is a new free and open source program that aims to solve this problem. When you visit the official website, the link will be in the video description, and click on the download button, you will be able to choose which Linux distribution you are using. Debian, Fedora, or Arch. If you are using a Linux distribution that is not based on one of these three options, select AppImage option, which should work on most Linux distributions. I am currently using Fedora, so I will choose this option. After downloading, we will install the program using the terminal. When we launch the program, we will receive a welcome message. When we click on Next button, it will first be necessary to agree to the terms of use by clicking on I agree button. Next, we will see a list of hardware requirements and dependencies necessary for the program to function. All missing dependencies will be marked with a red X, and next to each option, you will find a How link. When you click on this link next to the missing dependency, a website will open in your main web browser where you can see instructions on how to install those dependencies for your Linux distribution. After successfully installing all required dependencies, when we click on the Next button, we will be able to specify the location where WinBoat will install Windows in the virtual machine. The program essentially installs Windows within which all Windows applications will run, and then integrates them into your Linux. Once we chose the location, we will have the option to select the version of Windows we want. Since Windows 10 is no longer officially supported, I will leave Windows 11 checked. The default language is set to English, but if you like, you can change it. Click on the drop-down menu and select Preferred Language. You also have the option to use a customized Windows ISO file by clicking on Select ISO file and choosing the Windows ISO file you have previously customized. This option is not mandatory. If you just click Next, the program will install the official version of Windows that anyone can download from the official Microsoft website. After that, we will define the username and password. When we click Next again, we will have the option to specify the resources that the virtual machine will have. In other words, how many CPU cores, RAM memory, and hard drive space we want to allocate to the virtual machine. Adjust these options according to your needs based on your computer's capabilities and the requirements of the programs you plan to run this way. When we click on Next, we will be prompted to activate Home Folder Sharing, allowing us to share the home folder with Windows that will be installed. If you want this feature, check the option Enable Home Folder Sharing. This option is not selected by default, as the warning emphasizes this may compromise the integrity of your Linux distribution. When we click Next again, we will receive a summary of all the settings we have made. If everything looks good, click the Install button, after which the installation of Windows will begin. Depending on your computer's configuration, this process may take some time. To check the current phase of the installation, click on the link in your browser, which will open a page in web browser where you can see the current state of the Windows installation. Once the installation is successfully completed, you will receive a message saying Windows has been installed successfully. When you click on the Finish button, the program will automatically launch. In the Home segment of the program, the version of Windows that has been installed will be displayed, as well as the status of the virtual machine. In other words, whether it is online or offline, active or powered off. When the virtual machine is on, in this segment you will have a Stop button and a Pause button, which allows you to turn off the virtual machine when you are not using Windows applications. You can restart Windows simply by clicking the Play button. When you click on the Apps option, you will receive a list of all Windows applications that you can run at that moment. Since we have just installed Windows, we currently only have the applications that come pre-installed with this operating system. To launch any of these applications, all you need to do is click on it. For example, I will click on Notepad. The main advantage of this program is that it allows you to integrate all Windows applications into the Linux environment, at least from the user's perspective. Although these applications technically operate within the Windows environment installed in a virtual machine, users experience the feeling that those applications are running directly in Linux. This seamless integration enables smooth and natural usage without the need to switch between different operating systems. You can install new applications by clicking on the first icon in the App section labeled Windows Desktop. This will open the Windows environment running in the background. Here you can install any applications you wish to use, just as you would in Windows, since you are effectively operating within Windows in a virtual machine. For example, I will install Visual Studio, which does not function on Linux. After installing the program, when we return to WinBoat in the App section, you will see the Visual Studio has been added to the list of the applications, and you can now launch it with a simple click on its icon. You can install other programs you need in the same manner. Now that we have highlighted the advantages of this program, it is important to note certain disadvantages that currently exist. First, since applications run in a virtual machine, performance depends on the resources you allocated to the Windows during the installation. Consequently, programs that require more resources may run slower. Secondly, I have noticed that when launching demanding applications like AutoCAD, there is a slight screen tearing issue, which can be a problem for users involved in graphic design or photo editing. Additionally, considering the dependencies used and the way it operates, there are legitimate security concerns. However, it should be highlighted that the program is still in the testing phase, meaning there is not yet a stable version available. As you can see on the website during the download, it is indicated that this is a beta version. If you want to try out and test the program, you can download it right away. However, if you plan to use it for serious projects, it is recommended to wait for a stable version, in which the current issues will probably be resolved. In any case, WinBoat represents a positive step towards enabling the running of Windows applications on Linux. If you have any questions, suggestions, or ideas for future video content, feel free to leave them in the comments. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video, I hope you find it useful or at least informative.